What would Chet Coppock rather do? Interview Michael Jordan or introduce Hulk Hogan?
Oh, come on. I mean, I love Michael, and I made a lot of money with Michael doing Chevrolet spots and other clients, and I was part of the Bulls broadcast team when they won their first NBA title. But when you're in a wrestling ring, as I was so many times, and you're introducing Hulk Hogan, and you brought the heel in, and you've gone to the dramatic pause, and you say, from Venice Beach, California, weighing 310 pounds, he is a real American. He is the World Wrestling Federation heavyweight champion of the world. He is Hulk Hogan. Man, let me tell you something, your blood just curdles. The goosebumps, man, they're as big as fried eggs, if you know what I mean. I would much rather, anytime, even though Hulk is closer to 60 than he is to 50, if you tell me right now I could interview Michael Jordan on national television or go to a small town Hick Arena in Akron, Ohio and introduce Hulk Hogan, it's no contest. I want the Hulkster. And, you know, I think I mentioned in the book that Hulk and I once took a very interesting shower together. It was after his show at the old Rosemont Horizon, now the Allstate Arena. And there was only one problem after the shower, other than the fact that I felt physically humiliated for a variety of reasons. There were no towels. So Hulk and I had to dry ourselves off using hand dryers, which took about a half an hour. But Hulk Hogan is the essence of color, flamboyance, as is Michael Jordan. Michael, though, is a little bit too real. Hulk is fantasy land. And you know what? I'm a kid at heart, so give me fantasy land. I would much prefer to intro Hulk.
What's the only thing worse than a Notre Dame football fan after an Irish loss?
Well, first of all, you know, kudos to Notre Dame football fans for the obvious reason. They've sold out every football game they've played since they met the Air Force on Thanksgiving Day back in 1973. Not exactly, if you know what I mean, a glitter gulch attraction. We also had a national gas crisis going on at that time. Notre Dame fans are unique. Notre Dame fans generally cannot see through the prism. They believe that all things Notre Dame are all things wonderful. And for the most part, they are. It's a marvelous academic institution, the whole nine yards. But when it comes to football, Notre Dame fans are completely unrealistic. The only thing worse than a Notre Dame fan after a loss is a dead drunk Notre Dame fan when they don't cover the point spread. Now, just to clarify that again, so we all understand, the only thing worse than a Notre Dame fan after a loss is a dead drunk Notre Dame fan who's been tailgating since 9 a.m. beneath the Golden Dome, looking at Touchdown Jesus. He went over to the Rockne Monument, he's visited the Grotto, and then he looks up at his parlay card and goes, Notre Dame didn't cover? This has been a lousy day in the office. That being said, hey, Notre Dame football fans, you know Coppock's only having fun with your brothers and sisters. That being said, it might be time for a change. Keep an eye on things.